Exception handling allows us to deal with unexpected situations that may occur in our program. As an example, we'll pick opening a file using the file reader class in the Java IO package. NetBeans will then remind us that this class's constructor may throw a file not found exception, and if we try to run the program, the compiler will also point this out. To get rid of this error, we must catch the exception using a try-catch statement. This statement consists of a try block containing the code that may cause the exceptions and one or more catch clauses. If the try block executes successfully, the program will then continue running after the catch blocks, but if an exception occurs, execution will then be passed to the first catch block able to handle that exception type. In this example, the catch block is set to handle only the file not found exception. If the code in the try block could throw more kinds of exceptions, and we wanted to handle all of them in the same way, we could instead catch a more general exception, such as the exception class itself. This catch clause would then be able to handle all exceptions that inherits from this class, including the file not found exception. Keep in mind that to catch a more specific exception, we need to place that catch block before more general exceptions. Note that the catch clause defines an exception object. This object can be used to obtain more information about the exception, such as a description of the exception using the getMessage method. As the last clause in the try-catch statement, we can add a finally block. This block is used to clean up resources allocated in the try block and will always execute whether there is an exception or not. In this case, we should close the file that we opened in the try block, but only if the file was opened successfully. To be able to access the file reader object from the finally clause, we need to declare it outside of the try block. And because the close method can also throw an exception, we need to surround it with another try-catch block. Keep in mind that if we forget to close the file, the garbage collector will eventually do it for us, but it's a good practice to do it ourselves. When we encounter a situation that a method cannot recover from, we can generate our own exception to signal to the caller that the method has failed. This is done using the throw keyword followed by a new instance of a throwable type. Exceptions in Java are grouped into two categories, checked and unchecked, depending on whether or not they need to be specified. A method that throws a checked exception, for example the IO exception, will not compile unless it is specified using a throws clause after the method's parameter list, and the calling method catches the exception. Unchecked exceptions, on the other hand, such as the arithmetic exception, do not have to be caught or specified. Note that to specify multiple exceptions, the exception types are separated with a comma. Exceptions, like everything else in Java, are classes that exist in a hierarchy. At the root of this hierarchy, we have the throwable class, and all descendants of this class can be both thrown and caught. Inheriting from throwable, we have the classes error and exception. Classes descending from error are used to indicate non-recoverable exceptions, such as the out-of-memory error. These are unchecked because once they have occurred, it is unlikely that we can do anything about them, even if we catch them. Descending from exception, we have the runtime exceptions, which are also unchecked. These are exceptions that can occur in almost any code, and it would therefore be cumbersome to catch and specify them. For example, a division by zero will throw an arithmetic exception. However, we wouldn't want to have to surround every division operation with a try-catch. There is also an overhead associated with checking for exceptions, and the cost of checking for these exceptions outweighs the benefits of catching them. Finally, we have the other exception descendants, which are checked. These are exceptions that we can recover from, and that must be both catched and specified.